In this video, we'll show you how to use SMS marketing to directly engage with your audience. If you're new to this, you can think of SMS as text message marketing. Whether you want to send a discount code, a welcome message, or even announce a sale, SMS marketing can help you connect with your customers in a personalized way. Through our simple yet sophisticated builder, you can create, schedule, and send your SMS marketing all from within Mailchimp. Before we begin, here are a few things to know. SMS marketing is a paid add-on on an essentials plan or higher. We're working hard on international expansion, so keep an eye out for updates on where it's available. Before you can create an SMS, you need to submit an application and have it approved. Your application includes details like your contact information and terms and conditions. On average, carriers take about 2 to 5 business days to process an application. To learn more about this process, check out our article, Set Up Your SMS Marketing Program. Now that I've covered those points, let's dive into Mailchimp. We'll start on the SMS overview page. First, click the Create SMS button, and that will take you to a checklist. Next, in the message name section, click Edit. The name of your message is an internal label, so only you and your team will see it. I want to announce a sale for the Potted Planter, which is a fictional plant brand we use when teaching, so I'll name this Flower Sale and click Save. In the Recipients section, click Edit. Then you can use the Send To dropdown to add a new segment, paste SMS phone numbers, or choose an existing segment. For my segment, I'll choose All SMS Subscribers. Next is the dropdown for Do Not Send To. This is optional, but you can choose a segment to exclude from your send. After you've selected your recipients, click Save. The content section is where you'll create your message. Just click Edit to open the SMS Builder. If you need some inspiration to get started, click on Browse Templates. You'll have a bunch of sample messages to choose from. Once you see one you like, just click Insert, and then you can make your edits. Our templates are fully customizable. I'm going to create my message from scratch. So I'll click Close and head to a text box. Here's an important thing to note before you write your SMS. The content of your message has to follow SHAFT guidelines. These regulations prevent certain types of content from reaching inappropriate audiences. If you want more info on restricted types of content, read our article about SMS marketing with Mailchimp. For my message, I'll write Flower Sale This Weekend. Details at thepottedplanter.com. While you type, keep an eye on the character count. If your copy exceeds the character limit, it'll be sent as multiple text messages. Near the character count, I see one SMS, so only one SMS is needed to send my message. If you want to add an image, click the Add Media icon. You can then choose a file from the Content Studio or upload a new one. If you do decide to use media, there are some points you'll want to know. When you add media, your SMS becomes a multimedia messaging service. An MMS follows different carrier rate limits, and its character limit differs from SMS. You can add one image to an MMS. The file formats you can use are JPEGs, PNGs, or GIFs, or GIFs, whatever you want to call it. Moving on, we'll take a peek at the checkbox for pre-fill sender name. This is usually the name of the business, and it doesn't count toward your character limit. My sender name is The Potted Planter, which is right before my message in the visual preview. If you uncheck the sender name box, you'll hide the name of your business, but some carriers do require you to include a name, so we recommend adding it somewhere in your message. Up next is automatically shorten and track links. While it's not required, we do suggest shortening your links to save on character count. And by enabling link tracking, you can see if contacts have clicked links in your message, which could help you measure engagement. If you're on a standard plan or higher, you can use a branded SMS short link. First, click Link Settings, then toggle the Enable Branded Short Link slider to On. Enter the subdomain you want to use in the subdomain text box. Then click Save. Keep in mind, subdomains have to be 25 characters or less, and they can only include letters, numbers, or dashes. This is also a good time to check if your link is working. All you have to do is click on your link in the preview. All right, we're done with this section. The last checkbox we'll cover is include opt-out instructions. If it's been 30 days or more since you last contacted a recipient, you should check this box. Also, some mobile carriers might require opt-out language. These instructions do count toward your character limit. So if I uncheck the box for opt-out instructions, my character total drops. I do want to include the instructions, so I'll recheck the box. And now the line, text stop to opt out, is displayed. You're almost ready to send your message at this point, but it's always a good idea to test out your message. To do that, click send a preview, and then enter the phone number you want to receive the preview and click send. You don't need SMS credits to send a preview, but you can only send 15 previews a day. That's all I have for the content section. Once you're happy with your text message, click save and continue. This brings us back to the checklist. After the content section, there's an estimate on how many credits it'll take to send your message. You can get more details by clicking credit calculations. If you're good with your SMS credits, click send or schedule. By default, you can send a message between 11 a.m. and 9 p.m. Eastern time. The hours outside this time frame are called quiet hours. Mailchimp's quiet hours ensure that you send text messages that comply with laws and regulations. There are also rules for message cadence and the number of messages you can send. If you go over a carrier's limits, your text messages will enter a queue and they'll be sent at the next available time. Managing carrier rate limits and the cadence of messages is called throttling. Again, this is something we do to help keep your SMS marketing program compliant. To send your message at a future date and time, click Send Later and use the drop-down menus for select date and select time. Remember, you'll have to choose a time between 11 a.m. and 9 p.m. Eastern time. You can adjust quiet hours so you can send between 8 a.m. and 9 p.m. in your time zone. To make those changes, click Edit Quiet Hours. Just make sure the quiet hours in your areas are checked before you do this. When you're satisfied with your setup, click Schedule. That takes care of some background info. Let's move on to Send Now. If you choose this option, you'll have to click Send again to confirm. Then your message will be sent after a quick review, as long as it's between 11 a.m. and 9 p.m. Eastern time. You've done it. Good work. The last thing I want to show you is where to find your drafts and scheduled messages. You'll head to Campaigns and then click SMS. Then on the SMS overview page, go to the Recent Messages section and click Edit next to the message you want to work on. With that, I've covered how to create, edit, and schedule an SMS in Mailchimp. Thanks for following along. As for next steps, try sending your first SMS with us and look into our SMS reporting features. If you have questions, we've got plenty of videos and articles in our Help Center.